Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 3 Blind Eye. Well, we're getting back into the main quest now. It's been like over a month since we made any progress with... it's been like 40 episodes, I believe, since we made any progress with the main quest at all. So I'll be glad to get back into that. I do have a little bit of bad news, but I'm not sure who among you actually care one way or the other. The textures, the 4K textures I tried to install, it didn't work. Let's see, I have notes because I kept installing a little and then checking and installing a little and then checking, and it's the NPCs. The game was working fine until I just tried to install the characters, NPCs. Now, I could have, it's any one of like 100-something textures, assuming it's one. Could be more. So I'm not sure. I actually have no idea which of the NPCs it was. I tried re-downloading, you know, the zip file and everything, or the 7Z file, whatever. And yeah, same thing. So I could have tried to peg it down more, but there might be more problems. And that was relatively early on. It was about 3 hours in, and I'm like, you know what? Screw it. I don't know if there's more problems. I could, you know, try to locate that one, and I just have to keep, you know, repairing the game and then starting over, installing them, and seeing, you know, slowly homing in on which character it is, and that there's a problem, and then just not do that character. But the only problem also is that that character might look off, you know, from the rest, because everyone else are going to be 4K and they're going to be regular, you know, resolution. So, yeah, so they'll have less detail and everything, and it could be off-putting. Plus, I don't know, like I said, there might be other problems as well. So, that might just be the first one that there's an issue. Okay, I was having an issue here. I think we're going to need a new keyboard at some point. I finally got a mouse that works. Now I got a new keyboard. I was hitting escape to go here, and it was dropping me to Windows, not knowing that the Alt key was depressed by itself over on my keyboard. I'm like, why can I... It drops me to Windows automatically. Let me just restart the recording, just in case things got messed up. Okay. So these are the only things we have to do now. This is somewhere. We're going to find that in our travels, I'm guessing. That's in the Krogan DMZ Dranic system. This is somewhere in a galaxy. This is somewhere I'm guessing we haven't been to, wherever this is. Tuchanka, Tuchanka, Tuchanka. So let's head for the Krogan DMZ, shall we? I have fuel, I'm pretty sure. I mean, why would I be here if I didn't? Okay. I'm getting over a cold, so... I sound fine to myself, but just in case... I'm getting over a cold. My voice was majorly screwed up for about a week, so that sucked. I watched a lot of Lore Runner and Angry Joe. Nice. Oh, we got a fuel depot here. How convenient. So, our lock system in the Krogan DMZ. So, we're going to check out all these planets, of course. We also got Dranic and Nith. Let me just take a peek. Dranic and Nith. The other one of these in the Dranic system. Is that? Wait. Right. That's Krogan DMZ also. Okay, I forgot about that. I knew there was one other thing. So that's in the Dranic system. That's where Barla Von. So I'm going to take care of a whole bunch of crap here. One of them is the main quest, and three others is other stuff. Kind of think I might just go to the Dranax system and do that. Durak. So we'll check out these planets first. Durak is a small, heat-blasted rock lost in the blinding glare of the star Arrillac. It occasionally traps a trace atmosphere of gases blown in on Arrillac's powerful solar wind, which inevitably blows the gases back out again. The planetoid has a few valuable loads of heavy metals, which were sporadically mined by the Krogan at the height of their power. In the closing years of the rebellions, the five clans working the planetoid fell to fighting over a particularly rich deposit of iridium. All five clan warlords agreed to a crush, a meeting at a neutral location, to negotiate a truce. Unfortunately, all five arrived planning to betray their fellows. While the leaders and their seconds met, all their bases were destroyed by simultaneous hypervelocity cannon strikes. Left only with the food, water, and air in their hard suits, and with no way to call for rescue, the warlords apparently fought each other to the death. The survivors of the five Durak clans on Tuchanka still argue about which clan's warlord was the last one standing. Those fools. Kanan? I like Kanan. One of Kanan's hemispheres contains an impact crater 700 kilometers in diameter. Dubbed the Renkat Basin, it was mined for light metals in the interbellum between the Rachni War and Krogan Rebellions. Any obvious resource concentrations have long since been stripped. Kruban. Kruban is a tidally locked Venusian hothouse, its surface perpetually obscured by clouds of sulfur and carbon dioxides. The first group of Krogan brought into orbit by the Solarian uplift teams requested a trip to Kruban. The Solarians at first thought the Krogan were confused about the nature of Kruban's environment. The planet is named for a Krogan mythological paradise in which the honorable warriors feast on the internal organs of their enemies. In fact, Krogan astronomers had correctly deduced the nature of Kruban in the years before the global holocaust. In the two millennia since, Kruban had come to be thought of as an ideal test of one's toughness. Every year, a few Krogan attempt to land on Kruban and exit their ships naked in an attempt to prove their Kroganhood. The planet's surface is littered with the crushed, corroded remains of their ships. Only one, Shath Norda, is known to have returned from the surface alive, albeit with most of his bones crushed and all four of his lungs damaged by sulfuric gas. My god. Norda recovered from his trial to the adulation of his people. Until he died in 1943, he could lie with any fertile female he wished. Well, hey, you know, benefits. Gonna take a look at Tuchanka. Not gonna go in there yet. Oh, look at these things we got. Shroud facility. Cure the genophage. Oh, wow. Cerberus attack. Investigate Cerberus presence. You know what? How do I get to the... I can't move the text. Oh, I can move it with my middle mouse scroll thing. Okay. Cerberus attack. Investigate Cerberus presence and down vessel. Extract Turian survivors. Scarred by bombardment craters, radioactive rubble, choking ash, salt flats, and alkaline seas, Tuchanka can barely support life. Thousands of years ago, life grew in fierce abundance under the F-class star Arrillac, a Rake clan word meaning Eye of Wrath. Tree analogs grew in thick jungles, their roots growing out of shallow, silty seas. Life fed upon life in an evolutionary crucible. Excuse me. This world died in nuclear firestorms after the Krogan split the atom. A little ice age of nuclear winter killed off much of the remaining plant life. Okay, yeah, I got stuff in my throat. Wait, I stopped being able to, hold on. My scroll stopped working. In In recent centuries, many Krogan have returned to their homeworld. The reduced albedo has caused global temperatures to rise. In order to maintain livable temperatures, a vast shroud was assembled at the L1 Lagrange point. It is maintained by the Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission, CDEM, which is based on orbiting battle stations. CDEM advisory. Visitors to Chachanka land on their own risk. At their own risk, the CDM will not attempt to extract citizens threatened by clan warfare. Travel advisory. The ecology of Chachanka is deadly. Nearly every native species engages in some predatory behavior. Even the remaining vegetation is carnivorous. Travel beyond the guarded areas is strongly discouraged. Population 2.1 billion. Capital is currently Erdnot since 2183. CDEM garrison 2400 in orbital battle stations. And stuff. We will go there shortly. Ruam. The smaller of Arilax hydrogen helium gas giants maintains a small helium 3 recovery infrastructure. Although the depth of Ruam's gravity well makes it inefficient to export, visitors to the Arilax system often top off their fuel tanks at Ruam stations. The Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission, CDEM, maintains a token garrison to monitor any potential sale of fuel to known subversives and terrorists. Population 1,040, CDEM garrison is 20. Last one, where are you? You lurk somewhere. There might be something in that belt as well. I'll make a round trip around it. Maybe that? I'm not sure. Vol. I said Vol. Vol is a hydrogen helium gas giant named for an ancient Krogan deity that stood watch for enemies of his pantheon. The gas giant's moons are named after some of Vol's myriad eyes and ears. The only reason to visit the Vol system is scientific curiosity, which the Krogan lack. Alright, let's look around the asteroid belt here. Nope, that wasn't anything. I'm wondering if there's any discoverable things here. Cool to know we could fuel up here, though. Did I look at this? Dirac? Did I see that? I think so. Yeah. Alright, if I go here, or around here, I might be able to get all three of those. We're not going to be detected. Evidently not. See if we can find anything. There might not be anything here. Just gonna try a little. I'm not sure there's anything to find here. I mean, there's no Reaper reaction, and there's nothing. Oh, we're not finding anything. There's that too. I didn't think I got the edges. I don't think there's anything here at all. Alright, let's go to Nith, just because I want to explore this cluster. Actually, let's go to Dranic because it's closer. Dranic! Oh, I heard that.
Signal confirmed.
Oh my. Twenty units of fuel. Cool, we're at full again. 50%. Kellum. Kellum is a tectonically inert rock with an atmosphere of krypton, xenon, and argon. There are a few valuable loads of light metal scattered across the surface, but these are difficult to find. Most were mined out in the years leading up to the Krogan rebellions. Dor is a conventional methane ammonia ice giant. It is the main fueling port in the Dranic Cluster Gateway system. Pildea Station, the headquarters for patrol ships of the Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission, lies at the trailing Lagrange point of Dor. The CDEM logs all ships passing through the Krogan Demilitarized Zone and has the right to board and search them for contraband at any time and for any reason. There are no exceptions. At points over the last two centuries, diplomatic incidents have been caused when the patrol frigates boarded an Asari hospital ship, a battalion diplomatic courier, and privately owned human tramp freighters. What's a tramp freighter? These measures are provided for under the terms of the Krogan Armistice. While the Krogan were allowed to retain their government and personal weapons, any attempt to provide starship-mounted weapons to the clans on Tuchanka is punishable by law. Nearly a millennia after the war ended, the official penalty for smuggling prescribed weapons is still death by spacing. Population is 7,300. CDEM garrison, 1,100, not including patrol ship crews. Oh, this tiny thing. I'm like, there's a ring, but there's nothing here. Sazgoth. Oh, look at all those moons around there. That other planet, I just caught a glimpse of that. Sazgoth, I like that name, is a small ice dwarf with an eccentric orbit. During perigee, portions of its icy surface sublimate into a thin atmosphere of nitrogen and carbon dioxide, which quickly freezes again as it recedes into the outer reaches of the Dranic system. Cool. All these moons. So there's five moons. Rothla. I wonder if this is where Barlavan wants his thing. Once Rothla was a large ice dwarf with the statistics listed below. In the waning years of the Krogan rebellions, it was shattered into a field of debris by what is assumed to have been the test of an exotic weapon system. In the wake of the event, the planetoid was reduced to a relatively contained field of thousands of tiny moonlets rotating around one another, colliding and ricocheting. The method used to destroy the planetoid has never been deduced. The Krogan clan who performed the experiment apparently all died in the event. Ships that have traveled to the edge of the event's light cone observed a moment of extreme gravitational lensing around Rothla immediately before its breakup, but no other clues. A popular extranet meme put forward by Asari author Delce Arthesa insists that the Turians are covering up the existence of a Krogan superbiotic breed that was genetically engineered within Rothla. The CDEM enforces quarantine around the Rothla field, citing cases of amateur investigators whose ships come to grief in a debris field. Really? Superbiotic breed? That would be a biotic counterpart to Grunt, who's the warrior. That'd be cool. Anyway, we're definitely gonna search. Well, you can only search a certain amount. We can search these and then that. Oh, I found the fuel already, right? So the other, it's usually the way it works is we have one random thing in space and then another thing on a planet. And they're coming. How do I... Wait.
Evasion successful.
It was like off screen. That was weird. The discover thing. I gotta die as soon as I come in here. Wait, why are you so...
Reapers eluded.
I probably don't even have to move. It's like so... And I'm over this side now. Oh, why?
Faster than light jump successful.
I wonder if this is my new mouse. Is accelerated too much? It might be. Oh, I left without even... This time I'm on this side. Okay, just go right up to it.
Ugh. Reapers eluded.
Sorry guys, this is probably really frustrating to watch. I gotta get it, you know? I just don't have time.
Light jump successful.
Come from this side. If it makes a difference. It does make a difference. I think my mouse is accelerated too much. Start the scanner. Good thing everything's paused when we go into this. I found it. Well, this is Barlavon's thing. That'd be cool. Shadow Broker Wet Squad? What was that? Get the hell out of here.
Evasion successful.
Dranic 100%. Is that what we're looking for? Let's fuel up. So I'm not gonna make it to Dith and back. I'm glad there's fuel here. I'll keep going. So Dranic's done. And we have 66% assets. So I'm guessing there's no assets here. Let's go to Nith. I mean, really, if we found... Then there's one asset in Nith. Because that's two-thirds, and we have one here. Would actually make sense. I'm curious, though. Yeah. The location of Shadow Broker forces trapped in the Dranic system. Recruit them to the war effort and return to Barlavan. Okay. So, halfway done. Good to know that that's what that was. I knew it was something for Barlavan. I forgot. It's been so long. This is a giant star. We will now die inside it. The Nith system. The planet Manton. The Class B Blue Giant Nith was once the most strategically valuable system within Krogan territory. Though far too hot for habitable planets, Nith emits thousands of times the energy of a main sequence star like Earth's Sol. With help from Solarian uplift teams, the Krogan constructed a chain of solar power collector stations in orbit around Nith. These vast arrays beamed power to particle accelerators on the surface of Manton, which manufactured anti-proton fuel for warship thrusters. In the Krogan rebellions, the Spectre agents managed to get a virus into the computers of the solar power arrays. Every fifth array suddenly applied braking thrusters. The arrays behind them piled up and all were reduced to wreckage. This has since dispersed into a relatively stable ring system. Really? That's funny. The Krogan never had the resources to rebuild the solar arrays, depriving them of their fleet's main fuel supply for the remainder of the war. The particle accelerators still exist on Manton, but have not been used in thousands of years. Alright, so I'm guessing this is the first planet. Second is Tula. Tula's methane ammonia atmosphere traps the blistering heat of Nith, driving dayside temperatures up over 1,000 degrees. While some loads of useful metals are present, the planet's incredible heat makes mining impractical. What is this other one? Only over here. An ice giant. Vard is a methane ammonia ice giant. Until the Krogan rebellions, it had a sizable helium-3 fuel refining infrastructure. Once the solar arrays orbiting Nith were destroyed, the constant flow of anti-proton tankers visiting the system disappeared. There was little point to maintaining the facility, so they were shut down and abandoned. Today, the ancient stations are squatted by transients, criminals, and outcasts. Although few are safe for habitation, neither the Krogan nor the Council Demilitarization Enforcement Mission patrols care if they take their chances. Population is 2,072. Now, is this one asset going to be on a planet? I'm thinking yes. Unfortunately, these planets are really spread out. Oh, you have. Oh my god. I found fuel. No, no, keep going. No, no.
Reapers eluded.
We got them all. We got everything. 100%. Nice. And fuel to help us get back. Not that we actually need it, but we won't have to buy as much, which is awesome. I'm guessing this is going to be, yeah, the end of an episode. Sorry guys, I hope you weren't expecting the beginning of these missions. But that will be next time. At least we, you know, found that thing for Barlavan, so when we return to the Citadel, we can give that to him. Or whatever the hell. We're going to tell him about it. So thanks for watching. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.